G'day. Today we're going to talk about run screens on the MC1 panel. So we're going to go through the options that the operators can choose from on the machine. Let's take a look. With the run screen, we have three areas of interest. The value area in the top section, the run screen views, and then the toolbar along the bottom. With the values in the uppermost part of the value area, in the left we have the actual height from the tool point to the target model. We have a side distance, if we have a side reference set, and then in this situation we have a tilt value of the tool or the bucket, the cutting edge. We can change this view for different values in the settings, and then we go to the height and slope indicators, and here we can change from height on the left, side distance in the center, and cross slope on the right to height on the both left and right, and then side distance. To demonstrate, we just select that, and now we have the left tool height and the right tool height plus the side distance in the center. The value for the slope, just go back to the main menu into the settings again and height and slope indicators, and if we go back to the original setting that we had, we can choose to have the value for the tilt as an indicator bar instead of a digital value. So to select that, and then we have more of a visual key and not just numbers flickering around. Another feature that's requested from the market. So for the values in the second row of the value bar, we have displayed an offset for height, if there is one. Next value we have is the design or the reference model to sea level elevation. The next we have the tool point to sea level elevation. And moving to the next box, we have a chainage value. We also have a side offset, if there's one set. Then we have the model long slope value and the cross slope value of the model. The values can be changed, or the units for these values can be changed within settings. And you can also change how many decimal points are displayed, which is done here. So we've got meters, we've got imperial, we have 1, 2, or 3 decimal places to choose from. With the run screen views, we have various options available for the operator. With a tap of the screen, we have the views become available. If the operator has panned away from his machine, we have one on the left that will zoom him back to the machine. The next view along is the top view, which is what we currently see now. Then we can go to a 3D view, which is more interactive for the operator. Moving along, we have an overview or a map view of the site that also includes the position of your machine. Moving along, we have a more of a specialized set of pages now, where we have a bulking out page, which gives a cut and fill value. We have a long slope view of the tool. We have a cross slope view of the tool. And if a camera is installed and configured on MC1, we have this option available. In this circumstance, we don't have a camera attached, so here you'd see that view. If we tap the screen again, we can scroll to the next page, which is two panels, and you can choose the various options between the two panels. And again, we can go to the next page, which has three panels. And again, you can select or customize each of those panels to your liking. On the run screen, the operator also has the options to add widgets. From the main menu in the settings page, we got run screen widgets. Here we can select what the operator can add to the screen if he wanted to. Now, elevation indicator and the height for the tool point coordinates can be one or the other. So you can toggle between one or the other depending on the operator's needs. And in the run screen, we can see the widgets are all added. And another helpful thing for the operator. The operator can also have choices of themes that he can see the run screens in. So again, from the main menu, in the settings, we have theme and brightness. Here we can choose between icon theme, which is the traditional view. Next one was the night mode. which gives a black background, good for working with different light situations, working at night even. And the last is old-fashioned, and that gives a different contrast to the details on the model compared to the background image. The buttons along the bottom will be discussed in other how-to videos, so stay tuned for those, and thank you for watching. Now you're up to date with the customizable run screens. Thanks very much.